Hi everyone, welcome to our channel BA Civil Engineering. In this video, we will learn about Atterberg limits. Atterberg limits are also known as consistency limits. So before going to Atterberg limits or consistency limits, the basic parameter one has to know is about water content. So here, water content is the amount of water available in the soil. So based on the amount of water available in the soil, there are so many parameters which are dependent. So if you take soil properties like toughness, rigidity, plasticity, permeability, shear strength, compressibility. So all these physical properties are dependent on the amount of water available in that soil. So if the water content is less, then the properties may be different, and if the water content is more, then the properties of that soil is different. So that is why the amount of water content available in that soil is the deciding parameter for several physical properties, or it is the deciding factor for the behavior of the soil. So in order to predict the behavior of the soil, we have to completely depend on the water content available in that soil. As well, in order to know about the consistency limits, we have to know about the water content. Why? Because these consistency limits are also dependent on the water content available in that soil, and mainly these consistency limits has arrived from the variation of water contents. Variation of water contents, and how it is going to affect this variation of water content on the state of soil. So based on that only we got these consistency limits. Now depending on the amount of water content available in that soil, four states of consistency are developed. To explain the state of soil, so in order to know about the state of soil, how it was present, we are taking four states of consistency based on the amount of water content available in that soil. So what are those four states means? Liquid state, plastic state, semi-solid state, solid state. So now the boundary water content, the boundary water content at which the soil starts changing its states from liquid to plastic state, or either from plastic to liquid state. Similarly, the boundary water content at which the soil starts changing its state from plastic to semi-solid state, or semi-solid state to plastic state. The boundary content at which soil starts changing from semi-solid to solid state, or solid state to semi-solid state. So based on this, three different types of limits were given. Those limits are known as Atterberg limits. These Atterberg limits are also known as consistency limits. Why they are known as consistency limits means these are the limiting values beyond which the consistency of the soil is going to get modified. That is why these limits are called consistency limits or Atterberg limits. So one is liquid limit, two plastic limit, three shrinkage limit. So this is liquid limit and this is plastic limit, this is shrinkage limit. So from this we can know very clearly, liquid limit is nothing but the state at which the water content at which the soil changing its state from either plastic to liquid state or liquid to plastic state, that particular limiting water content is called liquid limit. Whereas coming to plastic limit, the limiting water content at which the soil starts changing from plastic state to semi-solid state or semi-solid state to plastic state, it is referred as a plastic limit. Yeah. And similarly for the shrinkage limit, the water content at which soil starts changing from semi-solid to solid state or semi-solid state to semi-solid state is generally referred as a shrinkage limit. So these three limits are known as the Atterberg limits or consistency limits of the soil. Now coming to liquid limit. So if you see what is liquid limit or definition, it is the minimum water content at which soil starts changing its state from state of no shear strength, state of no shear strength to minimum shear strength. State of minimum shear strength. So it is nothing but the minimum water content at which soil starts changing its state from state of no shear strength to state of minimum shear strength. State of no shear strength means that there is nothing but a liquid state. So when the soil is in liquid state, shear strength of the soil is zero. So that is why it can be said as state of no shear strength. Similarly to state of minimum shear strength. Minimum shear strength means a plastic state. During the plastic stage, the shear strength will be very, very less. So that is why we can say that the minimum water content at which the soil starts changing its state from state of no shear strength, that is liquid state, state of no shear strength to state of minimum shear strength, that is plastic limit, that particular water minimum or limiting water content is referred as liquid limit of the soil. Now coming to plastic limit. Plastic limit can be defined as it is the minimum water content at which soil starts changing its state from plastic to semi-solid or semi-solid to plastic state. So this is the limiting water content at which the soil starts changing its state from liquid plastic state to semi-solid state. So that particular limiting water content is referred as plastic limit of the soil. So here, when it is changing its state from plastic state to semi-solid state, soil starts losing its plastic nature, plasticity of the soil is going to get reduced, or it is going to get loose. The soil is going to lose its plasticity and soil becomes brittle in nature. So that is the reason when you are doing this plastic limit test, we say that the minimum water content at which the soil, which was rolled into 3 mm threads, starts crumbling. So at that particular water content, we'll be taking it as the plastic limit. That is the reason why, because here the soil starts becoming brittle and brittle, so that it can easily crumble at this particular water content. So coming to shrinkage limit. Shrinkage limit can be defined as the maximum water content at which soil will not undergo any further the change in volume on further lowering of water content. So we can say that on decreasing the water content available in that soil, on reducing the water content available in that soil, the soil tries to become harder or solidified. The soil becomes solidified. So that is why when it is being removed, when the water is being removed more and more, up to some point there will be change in volume in the soil. But a maximum water content, a limiting water content is there. Beyond that limit, further reduction in water content may not cause any volume change. That particular limiting water content is generally referred as shrinkage limit of the soil. So in this way also we can say shrinkage limit is nothing but the limiting water content between semi-solid state and solid state of the soil mass. So that particular limiting water content is called shrinkage limit. So if you observe this liquid state to solid state, the water content in the soil is going to get reduced, or it is going to get lowered or decreased. If the water content is very less, the soil will be in solid state. If the water content is more in the soil, then they will be in liquid state. So from liquid to solid state, there is fall in water content or decrease in water content. So when you are lowering the water content in the liquefied soil, it may reach plastic state. Further reduction in water content may change it semi-solid. Further reduction in water content may change it solidified. So that is why it is all these limits are nothing but water content, limiting water contents, liquid limit, plastic limit and shrinkage limit. All these three are nothing but limiting water contents at which the soil is going to change its state from liquid to plastic state, or plastic to semi-solid state, or semi-solid to solid state. So this is about Atterberg limits and consistency limits.